Hi everyone, and welcome to Rise of the Tomb Raider. So, last time out, we finished the first game in the reboot trilogy, and now we're jumping in to the second one. Let's overwrite this one, I suppose. Sure. Yes, I am sure. A good balance of difficulty sounds good to me.
What makes someone reach beyond the boundaries of human experience to face the unknown? As children, we question the world around us. We learn, we accept, and gradually we lose our capacity for wonder. But some do not. The explorers, the seekers of truth. It is these pioneers who define the future of mankind.
The others, they're done. No amount of money's gonna get him through those mountains.
The lost city's up there, somewhere.
That's gonna be a hell of a climb.
I'm not turning back.
I know.
You should stay here with them.
Not a chance.
One second, please, Lara. Subtitles on with color? Yeah. Let's turn the controller speaker off, because if it comes out of the controller speaker, it doesn't get picked up in game properly. Well, it doesn't get recorded properly, I should say.
Beyond from the summit.
All right, let's take it easy here.
Should have done that before I started the game, but it's fine.
Crazy.
We just need to keep moving.
Hey, even if we don't find anything up here, your dad would be proud.
I know, but I have a good feeling about this.
This reminds me very much of... of the opening to the original Tomb Raider. Yeah, because in the original game, the 1996 one, she's also on a snowy mountain trying to search for a lost civilization.
Shit, Lara. You're gonna give me a heart attack. Are
okay?
Yeah. Come on.
Looks like we gotta go through.
Well, at least it'll get us out of the wind.
Not bad. If the weather turns, we can hole up in this cave. Do you really think we'll find this lost city?
I know this is a long shot, but that old tracker said he saw ruins up in these mountains.
Well, I guess if I was going to hide a lost city, this might be the kind of godforsaken place I do it.
I just hope Trinity has a beatness to it.
Storm's getting closer. We have a couple hours at most.
Should be enough time. We're almost to the top.
What do you think?
We're close to something, Jonah. I can feel it. Just this last stretch to the top.
All right. Let's see what's up there. Feels pretty solid, but keep close to the wall.
Okay. Looks like we climb from here.
Keep your eyes open for falling ice.
Right. You ready?
Let's do it. There's lots of loose ice up here.
Let's take it slow and steady. Just stay with me.
Look out!
Oh, shit!
That was close.
Yes, it was. It worked out for us. Please do.
Almost there, Lara. You got it.
I wouldn't be climbing like this, I'd tell you. Yeah, I'm on.
Come on! Lara, I can't hold you! The rope is slipping! Come on! Come on! Climb!
Well, this is going about as well as the beginning of the last game. Lara is once again finding herself in a very bad situation. That looked painful. Two weeks earlier, London, England.
It is the greatest cruelty of life that we're all too swiftly taken from it. We age, we decay, we die. But what do we leave behind? Bones? Dust? What of the soul? Does it endure beyond our earthly existence? I believe it does. A truth lies at the heart of many myths and stories. A truth not of science, but something more profound. The key to unlocking everlasting life. I may have found the next piece to the puzzle, but I'm not alone in this search. They're following me, watching my every step. I know them by name now. Trinity. An ancient, violent sect with designs on controlling the future of humanity. I must proceed carefully for the sake of my family. If anything were to ever happen to Lara or Anna, I could never forgive myself.
I saw the gutter press was attacking you again. I thought you could use some company.
No lies. Were you followed?
Followed? Of course not. What's going on?
I think I found the tomb.
Oh, you can't be serious.
The myth of the prophet is real. Dad was right.
Lara, your father was unwell.
No. He was close to a great discovery, tangible evidence of the immortal soul.
I loved Richard. I would have married him if he'd asked. But he was a broken man. I don't want to see you end up like him.
But Anna, he was right. It was everyone else who was wrong. The tomb's in Syria.
Syria? Oh God, Lara, no. This is madness. Get your life sorted. Go home to the manor.
You know I can't go back there.
But this obsession ruined your father.
I saw something. Something I can't explain. Now I understand what Dad was going through.
It's all fairy tales. Nonsense. Don't go down this road. You know where it leads.
It's the only thing that makes sense to me now. I'm going to find the Prophet's tomb.
Zone now. You better be sure about this.
We're close. There should be an oasis in the canyon just ahead.
You're wasting your time. There's nothing out here.
Just keep driving, please.
It's your money.
Something isn't right.
Oh, that's just local militia.
You told someone, didn't you?
They paid better than you.
You both...
Damn, shit, they weren't supposed to shoot at us.
Get us out of here.
Shit.
Well, I sure hope so. You've been through a lot to get here. And we're back to just the one climbing axe.
There was something in Dad's research about this.
It was said the Prophet's tomb was hidden in the cliffs above one of the forgotten cities. Legend speaks of an oasis where the Prophet was laid to rest.
Well, let's hope we're in the right place. I don't see an oasis yet, but... I also don't see the attack helicopter that just blew up our jeep, so... You know. There's positives.
Some sort of marker. Byzantine script, but I can't quite make it out.
It's R3 for survival instinct now, okay.
Okay, he's shown here performing healing miracles. Dad's notes mention this. These are the miracles of the Prophet of Constantinople, unjustly murdered by order of Trinity. It's the Prophet, speaking with a foreign army. He convinced them to lay down their weapons.
Now I can translate the monolith, because my language proficiency is better.
My Greek is still a little rusty, but it's pointing to something hidden nearby. I'll mark down the location.
I appreciate that was just for a tutorial, right? But putting a marker to go, there's something right here, seems a little excessive. That's where I came in, right?
He led his followers through the desert to the oasis.
Our driver told us there was nothing here. Shows what he knew. Then again, he could have just been trying to discourage us, waiting for what he called the local militia, but I'm guessing is probably Trinity. We at least got to get away from the attack helicopter. Because we know that thing's not going to be friendly.
The Order of Trinity pursued the Prophet and his people relentlessly until finally confronting them in their hidden oasis.
A way through.
Fairly certain that's not how glow sticks work. I've never seen a glow stick pulse, ever. Trinity are not very nice people, are they?
my son. The Order of Trinity has received word that the Prophet's followers are building a great tomb at an oasis outside Berea. But more upsetting, while we thought they were building the tomb for their Prophet, Trinity now believes he still lives. We have learned he is preaching his heresy among the local citizens, drawing more to him daily with his tales of how he conquered death. He is a liar and a heretic, claiming miracles that come only from the divine. You swore he was dead. Have you failed us?
Or did he actually conquer death?
The Prophet, slain by the Order of Trinity.
I remembered that bit.
They're blasting their way in.
Yeah, let's get this open.
Let's hope this works.
Be awkward if it didn't, though. I did just purposely flood an area. Go, Lara, go. There's no camp flagged nearby. So, I'm going to assume... I'm going to assume it just saved after that section. I'm going to really hope it did. And I'm going to end the episode here. Because I know this is like a big old puzzle area and it's going to take a while to get through. So we will do that at the beginning of next episode. If you enjoyed this one, hit the like button below, or let me know what you thought in the comments, and join us next time for the next one.